Suppose you have an important presentation coming up. You're well prepared. You step into the meeting and feel knots in your stomach. You chalk it up to nerves, focus on the presentation, and nail it. Or maybe you're finally going on a date with your crush. When you enter the cafe and catch their sight, butterflies in your stomach take over. These knots and butterflies are not just in your head, but a reflection of something in your gut-brain axis. What is that? Well, let's find out. So, what is the gut-brain axis, and how does it relate to your mood and emotions? Also, how can you optimize your health by changing your food choices? We'll unravel all of this and much more in today's video, so keep watching until the end and discover the lesser-known secrets of your body. Let's start with the basics. Did you know that we have a second brain too? Yeah, we aren't kidding at all. Our gut is often referred to as our body's second brain. It's the controlling monarch of another powerful nervous system that functions inside our body, the enteric nervous system. But what about our central nervous system? Isn't it in charge of handling all of our nerve responses? Well, that's true. Our central nervous system is responsible for influencing our voluntary as well as involuntary movements. These include behavioral changes, mood fluctuations, sensations, and perceptions. It acts as a central commanding unit that passes an order for smooth functioning over the body. All these decisions are under the brain's jurisdiction. How we sense and perceive our surroundings, how we act in different situations, how we make decisions, and how we emotionally react. From telling our heart muscles to contract and expand, to telling us to breathe, it all starts and ends with the brain. Our central nervous system contains around 86 billion neurons. These neurons act as messengers and transmit information from one end of the body to another, helping our body function properly. So, if the brain itself does everything, then why do we refer to the gut as our second brain? Well, the enteric nervous system, with the gut as a head, is responsible for critical digestive functions. Regulating the secretion of digestive enzymes and controlling the movement in the gastrointestinal tract are some of the powers that come under its jurisdiction. But now the question here is, are these two systems intertwined, or do they work independently as two separate systems? Well, here, the gut-brain axis comes into play. What do we mean by the gut-brain axis? The brain and gut interact in fascinating ways. Our gut is known for housing a full-fledged community of microorganisms known as microbiota. Microbiota is responsible for all the functioning related to the gut. Aiding in digestion, providing support to immune responses, and your skin, it covers everything. Surprisingly, it influences our brain health too. 95% of our body's serotonin, or our favorite happy hormone, is made in the gut. So if something is wrong with your gut and you're facing some digestive issues today, then it's more likely that you'll be in a bad mood all day. On the contrary, our brain produces cortisol, a stress hormone responsible for many roles. And one of its prominent roles includes influencing the gut. So, if you're under stress of any form, the chances of upsetting your gut increase exponentially. The gut-brain axis is like a two-way communication system wherein if one is healthy, the other blooms, or vice versa. In what other ways can it affect us? Maintaining a healthy balance between the gut and the brain is crucial. Studies show that the dysregulation of the gut-brain axis can lead to disorders like anxiety, depression, and obesity. Obesity is proven to be a gut-related issue. Bad digestion and unhealthy eating habits can lead to obesity. It's a growing problem across the globe. Over 650 million adults and 340 million children and adolescents are obese. The gut can also affect things like anxiety and depression, all of which are under the brain's control. Studies show that 20% of adults are affected by anxiety each year. Although obesity and anxiety are poles apart, they're interrelated due to the gut-brain axis. A few cross-sectional studies have also implicated that antidepressant actions also lead to a reduction in the obesity level of individuals. Several studies suggest that the gut-brain axis is one of the critical reasons for the occurrence of diabetes, the development of eating, and stress-related neuropsychiatric disorders. Turning it into your favor. So, now we can say here that what goes on in your stomach is fully capable of impacting your brain as well. And if you want to be in a good mood, you must keep your gut happy. And a healthy diet is the key to a healthy gut. Have you ever wondered why stressful situations result in disastrous constipation, diarrhea, heartburn, indigestion, or stomach aches? We're sure you'll be able to connect the dots now. Yep, all of this is the work of our beloved gut-brain access. And all this while, you thought that the poor universe was conspiring against you. Now you know the secret. Eat healthy and cut down on your stress. Yes, it is that simple. But the question now is, what do we eat? To keep your gut happy, you should eat food that keeps the residents of your gut comfortable. Let's discuss some healthy food choices for your gut. Load your plates with these four powerful ingredients. Fiber. Your gut bacteria just loves fiber. Fiber helps fight constipation, regulates blood sugar levels, and aids in weight loss. According to the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics, you should consume 14 grams of fiber for every 1,000 calories per day. This somewhat translates to 24 grams of fiber consumed daily for women and 38 grams for men. But unfortunately, the average daily fiber intake in the United States is roughly 16 grams, much lower than the recommended dose. However, you can rectify this by having many fiber-rich food items in your diet. Fruits like apples, pears, and avocados, barley, chickpeas, lentils, berries, sprouts, nuts, and chia seeds are all loaded with fibers. So go ahead, choose any of them, add your flavors, and curate delicacies that suit your taste buds and your body. Probiotics. Probiotics are made up of good bacteria that keep your body healthy. Good bacteria are responsible for maintaining your immune functions and dealing with inflammation. We can also say it drives out harmful bacteria. Probiotics help deal with diarrhea, bowel diseases, constipation, and yeast infections. Yogurt is one of the best sources of probiotics. It's a healthy and tasty drink made up of fermented milk and is an amazing option. Or try kombucha, another bacteria-friendly probiotic, a fermented black or green tea known as kombucha. Polyphenols. Polyphenols are plant-based compounds that are rich in antioxidants. Their regular consumption boosts digestion and improves brain health. They also protect our body against various cancers, type 2 diabetes, and heart-related problems. All kinds of fruits and berries, green tea, leafy veggies like spinach, and yes, even dark chocolate and red wine are microbiota favorites. Beverages like tea and coffee are also rich in antioxidants and are lovely for your gut health. Tryptophans. Tryptophans are significant building blocks of serotonin, the happy hormone. Tryptophans are not synthesized in our body and should be obtained from your diet. Meats like lean chicken, turkey, beef, and salmon are rich in tryptophans. Other alternatives for tryptophans include eggs, tofu, soybeans, pumpkin seeds, peanuts, and oats. Since they're known for having serious impacts on our mood, stress levels, memory, and cognitive abilities, they've become one of the most crucial nutrients in our diet. Warnings to keep in mind. Another important aspect you should keep in mind is avoiding sugary food alternatives. And stay away from saturated and trans fat. They're not all bacteria friendly and may end up upsetting your gut health and, in turn, ruining your entire mood. Now that you know what to include in your diet, go to the nearby supermarket and do some grocery shopping. Experiment with your food, bake what you like, curate new delicacies, and savor their tastes. Discover new recipes and keep your gut happy with yummy foods. How about making banana coconut oats, whole grain noodles with a creamy green pea kale sauce, or a pan-fried salmon with celery? The list can go on and on. Savor what suits you best. Willing to get some more insights on health-related issues? Are you interested in knowing more about food for your health? Because we got a lot to share. Go ahead and take your pick. Watch What Happens to Your Body When You Drink Turmeric Water Daily, or 12 Healthiest Foods with Almost No Carbs and Sugar That You Must Eat. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both and learn more about staying fit and healthy. What do you think about today's video? Let us know in the comments below.